This is an Agilent ESOF EDA demo that shows how to simultaneously optimize a power amplifier's source and load impedances at the fundamental and harmonic frequencies in order to achieve a desired output power and power added efficiency. We will show simulation setup including optimization goal definitions, optimization variable definitions, and simulation results. I've copied the Harmonic Z-Opt example project out of the examples RF board directory into a working directory. This example has an A README file, like most of the examples. This is the Harm Z-Opt one-tone schematic. Before I explain its details, I'd like to explain why this is a slick application of ADS. Unlike load pull simulation, in this optimization, you're able to simultaneously optimize the source and load impedances at the fundamental and harmonic frequencies, as well as any other parameters in the circuit, including the bias point, in order to achieve your desired specifications. There are a lot of equations here, but they're pretty easy to understand. This is a close-up of the schematic. This is the amplifying device. This is the source frequency-dependent impedance, and this is the load frequency-dependent impedance. There are various current probes and node voltages defined for measuring the DC bias consumption, as well as input and output impedances. The VAR1 and VAR2 equations define the real and imaginary part of the source and load impedances at fundamental and harmonic frequencies, and within the brackets are the range over which these variables are allowed to vary during the optimization. The if-then-else statements for ZS and ZLoad define the source and load impedances to be functions of frequency. The optimization goals are defined here. One of them is power added efficiency, or PAE, and the minimum value is 35%. Another goal is for power delivered in dBm, and it's to be between 30 and 30.5. A third goal is that the real part of the input impedance at the fundamental is to be greater than zero. The equations for computing the power delivered in dBm as well as the power added efficiency are shown here. These make use of voltage nodes defined on the schematic as well as current probes. The available source power is allowed to vary between 3 and 15 dBm, and it's set here on the source. You could allow the gate bias voltage or the drain bias voltage to vary as well during the optimization, which would allow you to see whether better performance could be achieved at a different bias point. This shows some of the simulation results and indicates that with the data included in the example, the power delivered is only about 27.5 dBm and the power added efficiency is relatively low at just over 11%. Also included are the power delivered to the device, the operating power gain, the transducer power gain, thermal dissipation, DC power consumption, total input power, and total output power. This plot shows the optimal source and load impedances at the fundamental and harmonic frequencies. I'm going to rerun the simulation to see if I can get better performance. I'm going to allow the available source power to be as high as 20 dBm, and I'm going to allow the gate bias voltage to vary as well. I've launched the simulation via the hotkey, and we can see how quickly the optimization is completed. Now the power added efficiency is above 35%, and the power delivered is near 30 dBm. Hopefully I've shown some of the power and flexibility that ADS has for this type of simulation. It's easy to change the variables that you're optimizing, as well as the goals that you're optimizing for. There is another schematic in this example file that adds the minimization of two-tone intermodulation distortion products to the other goals shown earlier. These one and two-tone optimization setups are also in the amplifier design guide. This demo has shown the power and flexibility of ADS, simultaneous optimization of source and load impedances, and the achievement of different amplifier performance goals via optimization. Thanks for watching.